Hi folks, Glyn here, back with another video for you. This is episode 93, and this time I want to go through something that's going to be new to some of you, but a bit of a reminder for those of you who've been subscribed to this channel for a while. And it's a workflow that I have for getting the very best results when using the quick selection tool for making selections and cutouts. All right, so I'll try and keep this nice and brief. We'll take it through in logical steps. But before we start, just so that you know, this is actually a picture here of my buddy Dave Clayton from the movie Up inspired photo shoot that we had just a few short weeks ago. To give you an idea of the out of camera shot, there's Dave playing the part of Carl from the movie. So after I reckon about an hour or so's worth of retouching Photoshop, managed to get him to this point here. So now what we need to do is cut him out of the original background, and we'll actually go through the process to drop him into the background that you can see here. But we'll take it nice and steady. I'll try and explain things as we go through it, why I do that particular way. We're going to use the quick selection tool. Should have no problems doing this whatsoever, but we're actually going to do it to make two selections rather than just doing this whole cutout here as one. And I'll explain why that is as we go through it. So let's just get the quick selection tool, then press W on the keyboard. And very easily here, we can just click and drag over the body of Dave, and we can see that the marching ants there very easily picking up where Dave's outline is. So we're getting a really simple selection there. Let's just click and drag it down his walking stick, so it includes that as well. And you can see Photoshop has no problem. There's a few areas here that we need to just tidy up. This area here is the background we can see between the gap between his arm and his body. So let's just take that off, reduce the size of the cursor there, the marker. Hold down the Alt or Option key to get a minus, click into that area, and then that'll help us to remove that from the selection. So we don't want to have that bit there, like so. Now, when I've got a marching ant selection going around, well, actually, let's just look at the head. What I'm not going to do is include the head. Let's just go straight across there. We're going to do the head as a separate selection. So just go across it, something like that is fine. When I've got the marching ants, what I now do is just press Q on the keyboard to go into quick mask mode. This is a very visual way of me seeing how good my selection is. So anywhere that's now covered with this red overlay is what I've actually selected. So I'll now zoom in and I'll hold down a space bar, click and drag around the outline to see if there's anything that I haven't included or maybe that I do need to include. And straight away I can see here on the walking stick, gone a little bit too far over, got a bit of the background. So what I need to do now is just get a simple round brush, and I'm going to paint with a white foreground color. And all I'm going to do is just paint, and you'll notice I can actually remove that away from there. So that's no longer part of the selection. So hold down the space bar, click and drag around. That looks fine. That looks good there. Oh, there's a bit on the shoe that we've actually missed here. So there's a portion of the shoe and the actual shoelace. So now, again with this brush, I'm going to paint with a black color. And all I'm going to do is just paint over the areas that I've missed. And you can see now that it's been covered with that red overlay, which means it's going to be included in our selection. So let's just get that just there. We've got all the lace in. That's looking good. Zoom out just a touch. Come around here. And there's just a little bit of the background we've got just showing through between the hand and the actual body. So again, I'll just get this brush. I'll paint in white to remove it. So we'll just come into there like so. And then paint in black. Whoops, paint in black just to bring back the areas that we want like that. That's that one there. And we've got this little bit here, paint in white to remove it. And we'll just paint over just to include that just there. All right, so that's looking pretty good. That's a nice, good selection there of the body. So press Q to come out of quick mask mode. We've got our selection marching ants going around his body. That's taken a bit of work, so now let's make our selection nice and safe by going to the Select menu at the top of the screen, coming down to Save Selection, and we'll just call it something simple like Body, and then click OK. Now that's nice and saved and safe there, we can go Select and Deselect. The next thing we're going to do is actually make a selection of the head and the hair. All right, we're going to continue using the quick selection tool to do that. So let's just zoom in a little bit now. We're using the quick selection tool. Let's just click and drag around the head. Go right to the edges so we get the ears and the top of the hair like so. Now, there's one little thing to make a note of here, and this will really help with you making these selections using the quick selection tool, is that you'll notice that when you're selecting hair, you'll probably find there's bits of gaps in between the hair where you can see the background coming through. And as you come over this kind of area here, you can probably just about see it, where you see where they've got the gaps in the hair? That's where we can see the background. You don't want to include that in your initial selection. So just hold down your Alt or Option to get the minus and just drag the selection back away from those parts, because we can use something else very soon to pick those up and make it look a bit more realistic. So that's looking good. Check around the rest of the head. Make sure there's nothing else that we don't want to include. That's fine. So when we've got a selection like that, click on the Refine Edge button in the top of the options there to bring us into this part. And this is where you can first of all choose how you want to view your image as you're working on the selection. I think for this one at the moment I'll stick with on white. And then once we've got that, we can click on Smart Radius, and we can bring up the radius slider just a little bit at a time. This is the thing about when we're using this area here, as like most things in Photoshop, just do a little bit, test and assess it, see how it goes, move it a little bit more, see how that goes. Rather than putting the settings up too high straight away and it looking really bad, just bring it up nice and steady, let Photoshop do its processing and see how that's looking so far. So let's just zoom just a little bit more. Maybe I can bring that radius slider up just a touch. If I go too far with it, let's just drag it all the way up here, you'll start to know the picture starts to go a real little bit funky. We can see all this weird stuff starting to come in here. That's a bit too far, so let's bring it back somewhere around about there, maybe back just a touch more, something like that. Whoops, like that'll do. So now that we've got that, we can then use this Refine Radius tool, which is actually on by default. So when you bring your cursor over into your image area, you'll notice you get this little circle here with the plus symbol inside of it. You can use your left and right bracket keys to make it bigger or smaller. But now what you want to do is just drag this around the outside top parts of the hair here to see if Photoshop can actually pick up any of those fine hairs that we didn't get in the initial selection, like so. So drag around like that and then let go, and let's just see how that goes. Now it's difficult to see it with the gray hair on the white background, so now we can actually dive in and look in it on these other different views. Let's just go to the black and white view. And you can see that's not done a bad job. You can see all these little fine hairs going around the top part, especially. It's done a great job of picking it up. But there is like a little gray area here that's gonna affect the selection and how it looks in the final result here. So what we can do now is maybe adjust the contrast slider. Let's just bring that up just a touch so we can actually get rid of that there. You'll notice if you bring that up too far, you'll start to get rid of some of the very, very fine hairs. But just by bringing that contrast slider over to the right a touch, you will reduce any kind of gray, smudgy kind of areas that you're making with your selection. Something like that's looking good. And sometimes I do add just a tiny amount of feather just to soften the selection up. So maybe 0.5, something like that will be fine. Let's go back to the view on white. That's looking good. Pretty much finished in there now. So at the very bottom of this dialog box, it says output to, and this is how you can choose how you want to send this now back into the main Photoshop work area. I'm gonna actually leave it set to selection. So I'll click OK. It jumps back into the main image and we can see the marching ants going around the head. And all I'll do, again, because we've done quite a bit of work there, let's make sure we keep it nice and safe. We'll go to select, save selection, and this one we'll call head. And then click OK. Let's just double click on the hand tool in the toolbar here to bring our image to full view like so, and select and deselect, or just Command or Control D to get rid of those marching ants. So the hard work has pretty much been done there. All we need to do is combine the body selection we made and the head selection to make one complete selection that we can then cut out Dave from the background and throw him over into that new scene. So those areas that we selected and saved, if you go to the Channels tab over on the right-hand side, you'll see them underneath the regular channels that you'd expect to see. So you've got your RGB, which is what you're seeing on screen now. It's a combination of the red, green, and blue channels, all that information to give us the final image. And you can see as you click on those, this is what the red, green, and blue channels give us. But at the very bottom are those two that we saved. First of all, the one that we called body, the areas that are white is what we selected. And then if we click on the other one, we can see the head. So what we actually want to do now is combine these two to give us one complete selection. But to make sure that we don't make any errors and ruin all that hard work that we've done, I'm going to just click on the body one that you can see at the moment, click on the thumbnail and drag it to the very, very bottom and put it over the new channel icon and then let go. And you'll see that'll create a copy of it. If I double click on the name there, we'll just call that cutout. So we know we've still got, just in case anything goes wrong, we've got the body, we've got the head, now we've got one here that's going to be a combination of the two. And at the moment, that cutout only contains the body. If we want to actually add the head to it, all I'm going to do is hold down my Command or Control key and then just click once on the thumbnail of the head channel. So if I just hold down the Command or Control key, click, you'll notice now it loads the selection. You can see it in the main work area here. We've got the marching ants going around in the shape of the head. Well, all I need to do now is fill that area with white. So we go to Edit, Fill, and from the drop-down menu here where it says Contents, we can choose White, then click OK, and there we have a complete selection. We've got a combination of both the head and the body to make one complete cutout. So let's just go Select and Deselect. So there is the combined cutout. And what we'll do now is just click on the RGB thumbnail at the top to go back to our full color view. We'll go back to the layers, and now we can actually use that to cut Dave off this background and put him into that great background that's been drawn by Aaron. Now this bit's really simple. All we need to do is go to the Select menu at the top of the screen, choose Load Selection, and in the dialog box that appears here, we've got a channel drop-down menu. If we just click on that to open it up, we'll see here are the three channels that we actually created. The body one, the head, and the combined one that we called cutout. So let's just click on the one called cutout, then click OK, and you'll notice you get the marching ant selection around the entire body and head of Dave. We then just need to click on the layer mask icon at the bottom of the layers panel, now that we have our marching ants. Click on that, and you'll see we kind of virtually cut him off the background. We've actually just used the layer mask here. We've got the white areas, which are showing Dave. The black areas here of the layer mask are hiding the background. So we've actually cut him out non-destructively, which is definitely the way that you want to try and do this, just in case you need to go in and make any corrections at some point. Now that we've cut him out, we get the move tool, click on Dave within the work area, drag him up and onto the tab that contains the background you want to drop him into. Keep it held down, drag your cursor into the actual picture here, the background, and then let go, and you'll see that he drops nicely into that scene. All we need to do now is reposition him, and there's maybe one extra little thing I can show you which will then really make your selections and cutouts absolutely perfect. All right, so I've jumped forward just a few seconds to reposition Dave, and now I want to show you that one extra little thing. Now, if I zoom in just here, can you see how there's a little bit of a halo going around the walking stick and also around the bottom of his trousers and onto his shoes down here? You can see on this area here. Now, that is actually part of the original background when we did the cutout. Now, what you could possibly do here, and this is what I used to do, is just click on the layer mask, get a black brush, and then go all the way around trying to get rid of it. But that's a real difficult way of doing things. You've got to be very, very good with the brush not to keep painting away too much. But here's a really quick way of getting rid of it. All you need to do is click on the layer mask itself. And I'm going to hold down my Alt or Option key, click on the thumbnail of the layer mask to go into the layer mask view. Let's just zoom out just a touch. Now the haloing is only appearing really on the walking stick and parts of the body. So what I'm now going to do is get my lasso tool and make a very rough outline of the body part and the walking stick. So basically what I'm now doing is telling Photoshop to ignore everything else except what's going to be within this area that I'm drawing an outline around. So something like that. So you can see I'm not bothering with including the head and the hair. We took quite a bit of time to get that to look good. There's no haloing on that. It's just on the body and the walking stick. Now that we've got the outline on it, we're going to go to the filter menu, choose blur and Gaussian blur. And in the dialog box here, just a 1 pixel radius of blur is all you need to add. and just click OK. That's a really important step there, because the next thing we'll do, if you hadn't added any blur into it, it would look really obvious and the selection and cutout would look razor sharp and just not realistic at all. So now that we've done the blur, keep the selection active, hold down your Alt or Option key and click on the layer mask thumbnail in the layers panel just to go back to the color view like so. The actual layer mask is still active. We can see the frame going around it. Let's just zoom in now so we can see those halos nice and clear. Then we're gonna go to Image, Adjustments and Levels. We're not gonna use a Levels Adjustment layer from the right-hand side over here. We're gonna go to the Image menu, choose Adjustments and Levels. And then all we're gonna do is grab the black point here, the shadows. We're gonna click on it and drag it in towards the right-hand side. Now, as I do that, keep an eye on the halo or the outline going around the walking stick and on the shoes and the bottom of his trousers. The more I drag it in, you'll start to notice that that halo starts to disappear. So we'll bring it in just a little bit more to around about there. Now look, I'll zoom in just a little bit more, and can you see how it's completely gone from the back of his trousers, his shoes, and on the walking stick? Let's just bring that black point back again. So this was before, and here now, as we drag it across, don't have to go all the way across, just again, a little bit of time, take it as far as is needed. You don't need to go excessive. Just around about there is absolutely fine, and you can see that it's gone. So all we've literally done there on the layer mask, we've moved the black point over to add more black into the layer mask. And what that's basically doing is, it's crushing down on the selection of Dave's body. And as it's doing that, it's compressing it and compressing it and compressing it. And it's eventually that black is covering over the halo that you had going around the walking stick and the body. Click OK. Let's just double click on the hand in the toolbar to go back to full view, select and deselect. So there you go. There's just a very, very quick workflow to show you how I think I get the best results when using the quick selection tool. Hope it's useful to you. The picture here, keep an eye out, because I'll have that one finished hopefully later on today. There's a few extra little things I need to do now that we've dropped him into this scene. So keep an eye on it. But hope you liked it. If you've not subscribed to the channel, make sure you do it. Spread the love, and I'll see you next time.